Violent the, crime is increasing.
Killer
again.
Was so heavily armed.
The National Rifle Association. They don't even want you to have those facts close the gun about gun violence.
Hi, I'm Henry Craddock.
I'm Mackie Mallison.
And I'm Daniel Gotkowitz.
In this past year, there have been numerous mass shootings.
These shootings have left Americans frightened and unsettled.
We think that the biggest issue Congress should address in 2014 is gun control.
We first talked to Dr. Frank Calistro, a criminal psychologist, about his opinion on gun control.
Well, being a criminal psychologist has caused me both to be involved in a lot of criminal cases involving firearms, and has caused me, maybe more importantly, to study very carefully all the scientific literature that relates to violence involving firearms. In the course of all of that investigation and study, what I found is that, several things. One, our society regulates firearms just fine, in much the same way that we regulate motor vehicles. So even though there isn't a constitutional amendment that says we have a right to have a car, and there is one that says we have a right to have a firearm, they're treated really more as a privilege than a right. And the majority of people who own them use them responsibly. The people who use them irresponsibly or criminally, well, at the very least, they don't get to use them or have them at all. Usually, whatever sentence is meted out as a result of the crime is greater because the firearm is used with it, okay? Bottom line is, firearms don't cause violence. Violent people cause violence.
The compromise, the main one I would say, would be to make background checks a little lengthier, to go more in depth of somebody that may have had mental illness and or other problems such as domestic violence, restraining orders, things like that. Although they do check them right now, I think that we could compromise on the fact that the background, in order to get a firearm, it may be a little harder to in the future.
I support gun control. And I support it because the number of gun deaths and the number of injuries in this country, it's completely unacceptable. And unless we change the way we handle guns, those deaths and those injuries will continue. The ones that make the paper that you read about, the big shootings, they're horrifying. But the number of young people who are accidentally shot, or who tragically take their own lives, the number of people who commit suicide at times is horrifying. And people really need to understand that having a gun in your house presents a risk.
About 30,000 people die by firearms each year.
In January 2013, President Barack Obama presented his plan to prevent gun violence in the U.S. His plans include improving the background check system, banning assault weapons and large capacity magazines of ammunition, creating and enforcing stricter trafficking laws, and increasing the study and knowledge of the gun violence epidemic.
Guns are too easily accessible to criminals, people with mental issues, and other dangerous people.
I guess my priority, I feel strongly about assault weapons and others that have military applications, not things that people need for hunting or if they want to use it for self-defense in their home. Although the irony is, and those of you who've studied it know, that people with guns in their home are more likely to be subjected to gun violence, and that the victims are very often family and friends.
The issue there with firearms with large magazine capacity or can hold higher capacity is not one that the particular gun is any more dangerous or any more vicious or any more of a problem than any other firearm that can hold a single round. The issue is with the person behind the gun and what their intent is.
And I do think that you can respect the Second Amendment and allow people to have a weapon to hunt, or if they feel despite the evidence that they think they're safer if they have a gun in the house, even though they're more likely to have a family member die if you have a gun in the house. That's their choice. But I do think that that we need to reassess the range of firearms that we allow people to have, how much they buy them, and what they do with them. We need to treat gun violence like a medical issue.
That Major County Sheriff's Association felt that gun control in and of itself would not solve the complex problems of extreme gun violence across this country that's happening each and every day.
A dozen more killers, 100 more. How can we possibly even guess how many?
The NRA's proposal for more armed guards in schools may be helpful in some instances, but it falls far short of the strong, serious, comprehensive action needed to stop the kind of horrific tragedy that occurred in Newtown last week.
The Second Amendment is a very controversial topic in the U.S. It states that people have the right to keep and bear arms, but is this still relevant in the 21st century?